Hello everyone, my name is Dr. John Adam here with Pawsitive Health, where we believe client education improves pet health. In this video, I'll go over a disease that affects over 50% of our pets today, and that is arthritis. Now, there are many types of arthritis, such as autoimmune disease or an infection, but usually when people hear about arthritis, they are talking about the disease process called osteoarthritis or degenerative joint disease. This is a very in-depth topic, and to make sure I don't make this an hour-long video, I'm going to go over a basic overview of what osteoarthritis is, the risk factors for it, how we diagnose it, and in future videos, I'll go over more in detail on the management of osteoarthritis. So what is osteoarthritis? It is a chronic inflammatory disease process resulting in cartilage loss in the joint, thickening of the joint capsule, new bone formation around the joint called osteophytes that lead to pain and dysfunction of the joint. This is usually secondary to repeated stress and trauma to the joint, such as when your pet injures their cranial crochet ligament in their knee, which is similar to an ACL injury in people. It also can be when a joint has developed abnormalities, examples being hip and elbow dysplasia, and luxating patellas, where the kneecap pops out of place inside or outside the knee. There are many risk factors for osteoarthritis. Genetics, of course, is a major factor in breeds like Shepherds and Labradors that are prone to elbow and hip dysplasia. Also, Chihuahuas, Pomeranians, Yorkshire Terriers are prone to luxating patellas. It looked over factors of obesity and is a key component in management of osteoarthritis. Other factors include age. Older dogs tend to have more arthritis than younger. Improper nutrition, especially with larger and giant breeds. I had mentioned before, past injuries to the joints such as cranial crochet ligament tears or fractures, and certain diseases such as Cushing's, diabetes, autoimmune, and infections. The signs and symptoms of osteoarthritis are due to impaired activity and mobility of the joint, and also pain. This includes stiff gait, hard time getting up, limping, and reluctance to move or jump. The pain elicited by osteoarthritis causes a change in behavior. It will also cause your pet to be sensitive to being touched, especially around the affected joint, as well as causing difficulty to go to the bathroom, since posturing to go is unfortunately painful, and so our pets will avoid going until it's absolutely necessary. Diagnosing osteoarthritis can be challenging, especially early in the disease process. Us veterinarians usually start with a thorough orthopedic exam that includes analyzing their walk and or run, and palpation and manipulation of the joint. Usually radiographs are performed to assess the joint and surrounding bone. However, it is usually more difficult to use radiographs to assess disease in its early stages, and when we do see changes on our films, it is usually pretty far along. We also perform radiographs to make sure we don't see any other ugly diseases such as cancers, infections, and fractures. Other more advanced diagnoses that can be done are CT imaging, MRI, and arthroscopy, where a small rigid camera is put into a joint via a small surgical hole, and then the joint is explored by the surgeon for any abnormalities. I hope you found this video helpful. If so, please hit the like button down below. Like I had mentioned in the beginning of this video, this topic has so much more to discuss, so please subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for future videos that will go in more depth, especially on the different management options of osteoarthritis. If you have any questions, comments, or future topics you would like me to discuss, please leave a comment down below. Thank you very much, and see you soon. Diagnosing osteoarthritis.